Well, welcome to Vegas Live with Ninon. And as we know, Vegas is full of people from all over the world, from the entertainment business, and they come from all walks of life. I have Paper Pat with me. That's his, that's your stage name, right?
Stage name.
And you are a rap singer.
Yes, ma'am. Rapper, songwriter.
Songwriter. Yeah. He kind of does it all. He's from San Diego, doesn't exactly live in Las Vegas, but, you know, anybody in the music business ends up in Vegas, right, you know, for a few weeks or whatever the case may be, because this is the entertainment place of the world, right, for the music industry. How good has Vegas been for you?
It's been lovely. Every time I come to Vegas, I'm either doing event somewhere, or, you know, I hit the strip and know 6-7 people based off of what I've done before. So
really?
I love it.
So
yes,
you do very home. He does very well in Vegas, and you know, there's so much competition out there. There is no competition.
Elvis is my only competition. Hello, Elvis guys. It's
well,
Pat.
You're sitting this Elvis. This is the Elvis Presley booth.
Yeah, I know. I heard.
You heard that? Yeah. Huh? The word's already out. It's the red couch and the Elvis Presley booth.
But that's the way I look at it, though. You know how there's Elvis on every corner.
Yeah, Elvis on every corner.
You know, it's
so
same thing
your,
with he, the,
that's your competition.
Yeah, I'm just leave it at that. Yes.
What made you go into the rapping business?
It was a way to
express yourself.
Express myself. Yeah, there's no other outlets besides rap music.
Yeah.
So when I originally jumped into it, it was more. Yeah, rebellious, seem, you know,
yeah,
so people get the wrong idea of
yes,
it, you know.
But yeah, but people sort of, it's a lot of the people that come from the inner city are people that
right,
come from a place where they haven't really been too happy
right,
yet.
Right.
And so the with the rapping, there's a way of releasing.
Releasing me, telling a story. I mean, my life's whole life's been a story, so it's pretty much getting it out there for people to hear. And people go through the same things I go through in my music from time to time,
yes,
you know.
Yeah.
It's giving life. Like, when I rap, I feel like I'm saving someone.
You're helping,
you know,
someone.
You know, yeah, that's what it, that's
and
what it is.
And the reason he's saying that is because, actually, he's you are a survivor of cancer.
Two-time survivor.
Two-time survivor of yeah, cancer. And what cancer?
Hodgkin's lymphoma.
Hodgkin's lymphoma?
Yeah.
And what was the other one?
Both times.
Both
Hodgkin's
times.
Lymphoma at 18, and I'm in remission now 2 years. I had a stem cell transplant January 15th, 2015.
Yes.
Yeah, so I'm still, you know, getting better, recovering,
getting
remission
better
from it.
But you know, the funny part about
hair's
the whole
back,
thing
you know,
is the hair's coming back. He's doing well. Yeah.
But it's an option, you know, you're like, ah, oh, just grow a beard, you know,
so
grow a ponytail. Like, yeah, I can do it now. Yeah.
But you, it, actually what he's talking about is through the music has brought you back again. That gave,
yeah,
that gave you the inspiration.
Yeah, yeah, I did. And I felt that I gave a lot of people information. I took time off of my music before the cancer the second time.
Yeah.
I was, my artist, like I rapped, it was profanity. Everything sells. I still do it to this day. I still write the sex songs, the drug songs, because everything has a dollar at the end
but
of it. But I was making that my image, and it really wasn't.
It wasn't your image.
Yeah, so it took me to go through cancer and chemo and losing people, because how many rappers, you know, how many girls in the videos want to go hang out
yeah,
when you're doing the chemotherapy, you know,
yeah,
so all those people kind of vanish away.
Really?
So, I took time off for the music, my image, and you know, everything. It was, I mean, you just worked.
So you were feeling a little bit down.
Right, kind of down, but at the same time, I was building myself.
But did you also feel that you had become kind of lonely, and this is where you had an inspiration to write, to start
awakening,
rapping?
Yeah.
You know, yeah, start realizing that.
There's different lanes in my music. I can rap different things, and that's where I came up with the idea of Family Fortune Fame. And that was my album I dropped after my cancer. I got back into the game. This is the album, Family Fortune Fame. And I mean, all proceeds go to my kids' college tuition funds. So I put it on myself.
Okay.
Got my own distribution deal on it, so nobody gets anything but my kids, you know. And it's more motivational music, and I kind of tell a story of everything.
Tell a story of your cancer.
My cancer, how my views of Family Fortune and Fame, how people have it twisted, how family doesn't really, like, it's not really family now in these days, 2017. Like, there's no family, there's no family reunions, there's no
family.
Yeah, there's no family anymore. Family, the thought of family is friends that's really close.
Close
we start
close.
To call each other family. We really start to hang out more than your initial
with
blood.
Your initial family,
and it's like kind of dying out.
So you still have your mom and your dad?
I do.
You do? You have any brothers and sisters?
I do.
You do?
Yeah.
And are you all together still, or are
it's
you
separated?
All
we're
separated?
You know, from time to time we come together. Yeah.
But not as much as you really should.
As I want.
As you want.
Yeah, it should.
So you were just saying that when you went in for therapy, you know, when you're doing all the rapping, you have all the girls around,
right.
You have everybody around,
that's
you're going
the,
to therapy.
The lifestyle, right?
Yeah, the lifestyle. So you're going to
get cancer.
Therapy, and nobody's there.
I mean, a few people, and those are the people I keep around now. My best friend here, she stood by my side through the whole thing. Chemotherapy, stem cell transplant, and
but not many.
But everybody else, everybody who was in it for the drinking and the partying, they vanished.
They all vanished.
They all
so
vanished.
So that's that. You take something from that, so you can take something from a bad thing into
right.
a good thing.
Right.
So then you can write a song about
and
that.
And I've made a whole album about it.
You made a whole album
about it.
Really?
Yeah, just to be motivating, because at that time, you got to understand, I used to do all this negative music.
Yes.
So
because it was.
And then I became positive. I got this Facebook page. It's called Praying for the Paper.
Okay.
So I started this blog page when I first found out I was going cancer, and I kept it up adamantly. I have followers on there, and I still have this page to this day. I have Motivational Mondays. Every Monday I get on there, and I let people keep up with me. So I gained genuine fans based off the fact of me being a two-time fighter of cancer. Like, I fight cancer, but I fight cancer's Ali, you know? Like, I really attack cancer. It's, like, not even natural, you know? Like, I go out to cancer killing.
So you found a road, an avenue.
So these people are looking for my music now, and I don't want to, like I said, sex sells and all that stuff sells, but that's not for these genuine people. These people need some good music.
They need some
They want to know how I felt, what I was going through. So Family Fortune Fame is the album, like, that I gave to, like, everybody, my family, my fortune, my frame, my friends.
Yes.
You know, and that's been my motto forever. And, I mean, I put it out, and that's what I'm circulating, promoting. It's on iTunes, Google Play right now. And it's just
a
new lane of music.
It's working.
A new lane of music, because, like, I can express myself now.
Yes.
You know?
You're not inhibited by anything anymore.
And I'm not into the following.
I feel sorry for me.
Yeah.
So now you're
but nowadays people are very trendy.
Yes.
So that's
very
my
trendy.
Being different. If I'm not like them, people won't accept it. You know.
No.
But then once they hear the greatness of it, they, you know, it grows on them to love. You know, like, you can only accept it.
So you count yourself as being somebody very different out there.
Right.
And the reason he counts himself as that is because of what you went through.
Right.
And I'm not saying you used what you went through. You expressed
molded
what you
myself
went
off it, expressed
and
it off
you,
of
and
it.
And you motivated yourself. And do you feel that has cured your cancer?
I think me being positive, motivating, and keeping it up and not having that, it does. Because cancer,
yes.
My last stage 4 cancer, stem cell transplant. And I'm comparing myself, I'm still young, I'm not even in my 30s, you know, I'm comparing myself to other cases, though. And me being positive, like, people are down.
They're down, period.
And then I'm collecting stem cells. I should be in the hospital for 3 days, collecting in a day. I'm recovering from my transplant like this, you know. But then it makes
that's
you.
That's the attitude you're taking on.
The neighborhood I grew up in, they don't tell you about health insurance. They don't tell you about none of these things. So I'm young, black, and American. Like, some stuff I have to learn on my own. I have to learn how to, like, this is because if America, you don't have medical insurance and you get hit with something like cancer, it could be financially
destroy you.
But then, and cancer is on, I can write for 6 months because chemo brain and things like that. So it's still a challenge every day. I still haven't got my original appetite back. But at that day, I'm progressing for the better and motivating. But there's no cancer patient rappers. There's no one I can go and listen to who could tell a story about cancer. That's what I was in. I was in that lane at the moment. Like,
yes.
Okay, I don't want to hear all this turn up music. I can't go party.
No,
I can't go outside. I catch a cold, I'll die. You know, my immune system is a baby. You know.
Can you rap a little bit of something? I'm putting you on the spot right now.
Right.
Can you rap a little bit of something about bringing the cancer into your rapping? Can you do anything?
I can do that.
Do something. Go ahead, do it. Go on, go out there and do it.
I'm a survivor, two-timer. Cancer gave me life, but I'm a beater, never beater. Life, I have to cheat her. Vegas lights keep them bright. That's like everywhere I go. Choke that cancer by the throat, just to let you know. That's just off the top, you know. But
yes.
Yeah, cancer was my motivation for a period of time, and it still
is.
It still thrusts me. It's still giving me life, because at a point in time, I didn't like I than have outlook on life.
He just said something really beautiful. He said the cancer is giving him life, whereas everybody else is thinking the opposite, so it's not giving them life.
It woke
me
up.
So you twisted it around, woke him up.
And that's how my thought process has been with everything I do in life. Like, I take negative energy and I channel it to positive energy. Instead of dwelling on an argument, you can go be creative. Okay. And I do some pretty creative stuff, like anything.
And I think,
you know,
beautiful.
Anything I can think of, I try to do it and, you know, and try to
this
make it happen.
This is my type of guy, because I'm always a positive thinker. I always think
positive thoughts,
and nothing is really that bad. Nothing is really never, ever that bad. It will sort itself out.
It always does
sort itself out. But I think we create more things that may happen.
Right.
That never will happen.
Right.
I mean, we create all these crazy
the
things,
thoughts and
it's like never happens. So it's the
you got to be motivated. You got to like take it and be creative with it.
As I always say, Pat or Paper Pat, that
yes.
I cannot relive this morning. Well, maybe I don't want to. Actually,
I'll remember.
I can't think of things that I really. But you, I can't relive any of it. I can only be in the moment.
Be in the moment.
And go forward.
Prepare
and
for
I
the
think,
future.
And that's what you, and you are preparing for the
yes,
future.
Ma'am.
And you feel good. So I think any cancer person out there, don't feel, you know, bad.
Don't Stop let it eat you alive. That's how I feel. That's how the people with the cancer beat you, because you're letting it beat you.
You're letting it.
You have to get active. You have to move around. Just don't sit there.
Yes.
Once you sit there, that cancer is gonna get to you.
Well, yeah, because you're all relaxed. It's gonna, it
no,
can go
get up and do what you still do. If you still
fight it,
if you still go to that grocery store, run around, like do what you have to do. Don't let it bring you down. Stay moving.
What a great message that is. Incredible message. Well, thank you for coming.
Thank you. It's a blessing.
It is a blessing.
Yes,
thank you so much. Yeah, he's a great guy, isn't he? So take a leaf out of his book. Move forward.
Yes.
We'll be back.